Here are three ways to share PowerPoint slides in OBS Studio. These methods will work even if you're only using one monitor in your setup. All the links are in the description, so now let's jump into OBS Studio and let's get PowerPoint set up. I'm going to start by adding PowerPoint as a window capture to our scene. So I'm going to click on the plus icon here in Sources and then Window Capture. And I'm going to call this PPT and press Enter. Now this is going to give me a list of all the windows that I have running. I'm going to pick the PowerPoint window here and click OK. Now OBS Studio is showing the main PowerPoint window, but let me show you the main problem that we're going to be solving in this video. If I now go back to the PowerPoint application and press F5 to start the slideshow, it will go full screen on my monitor, but it will actually not be picked up as a full screen slide presentation inside of OBS. And the reason for this is that full screen slide presentation is actually running in a different window. But this is easy to solve, and here is the first method. I'm going to go back into OBS, click on properties for that window capture that we added, and then I'm going to choose a different window. Instead of this PowerPoint Excel window here, I'm going to choose the PowerPoint that is actually showing the full screen presentation. And as soon as I do that, I can press OK, and now I have it shared correctly inside of OBS. Here I can also adjust the position of the window so that the window capture is actually capturing the entire presentation. Let's move that up a little bit. There we go. Once I'm capturing the slideshow correctly, I can go back into PowerPoint presentation mode, and then I can browse my slides from there. And you will see here back in OBS that they're coming through very nicely. The problem with this setup is that I still have a full screen PowerPoint slideshow running here on my system, and that can be a little bit wonky. So I want to show you a different way of adding the slideshow to OBS. For this one, I'm going to quit the slideshow here inside of PowerPoint, and then I'm also going to go back and change the source here by clicking on properties, and I'm going to pick the original PowerPoint window that we have, and we're actually going to be running the slideshow inside of that window. The way this works is that I'm going to go back into PowerPoint here and then click on Setup Slideshow. Usually you have it on this full screen sharing, which is the first option here, but now I'm going to pick the second one, which is a windowed slideshow. And as soon as I click on OK here, and when I start the slideshow, it's actually going to show it inside of the same PowerPoint window so that I can browse it here. Now that the slideshow is running in a window, it will actually be captured correctly inside of OBS Studio. The layout here looks a bit different. At the very bottom, we have some controls. I can hold down the Alt key and just cut them out, and then I can adjust my window so that it fits nicely into the window capture that we have inside of OBS Studio. The limitation of both of these methods is that when I want to change slides, I actually have to go into the PowerPoint application to scroll my slides back and forth. So what I actually prefer to do is to use the built-in image slideshow inside of OBS Studio, and that's going to be our third solution. In order to use the image slideshow, the slides need to be saved as images. Luckily, this is very easy to do inside of PowerPoint. I'm going to switch back into the PowerPoint main window here, stop that slide sharing, and then I'm going to go into File and Save As. Here inside of the normal PowerPoint Save As dialog box, I'm going to pick an image format instead of the normal slide format, and the one that I'm using is the PNG file format. So all I'm going to do is click Save here, and it's going to ask me how do I want to save my slides. I'm just going to click on All Slides right there, and then click on OK there, and all of the individual slides will be saved as individual PNG files in that folder. Back in OBS Studio, let's add the image slideshow. I'm going to start by hiding the PowerPoint window capture that we had before, and then click on plus and image slideshow. In this dialog box, I'm going to scroll down to the bottom here where it asks me where are the image files located. I'm going to click on plus and then directory. And then in here, I'm going to paste the directory that has the PowerPoint extract files that we made earlier. So I'm just going to click on select folder there. And you can see that per default, it's going to cycle these slides every 8,000 milliseconds. I don't want that. I want it to be manual. So I'm going to go in there and click on manual instead. And what I can do now is that I can cycle through these slides with these buttons right here. This is also a good opportunity to make sure that this whole presentation is filling the screen. I can either grab the handles here or just press Control F to make sure that it fills the whole screen. And now I can browse the presentation easily here with these buttons. The main benefit of using the image slideshow method is that I can control the slides within OBS Studio. I don't have to go into PowerPoint to change my slides. I can just click here, and I can even bind these commands to keyboard shortcuts. This is actually the method that I prefer to use when it comes to sharing slides inside of OBS. So let me show you my full slide sharing setup that I use for live streaming and for video conferencing as well. This right here is how I prefer to share slides. With this setup, I can switch slides with my keyboard commands, but I can also switch layouts. For example, I can put my camera in the corner, I can remove it completely, I can go to the webcam only view, plus I can go back to my split layout as well. If you would like to copy my scene collection, you can download it at marcuspresents.com/OBS. Particularly for video conferencing, I think this is a powerful setup because I can easily remove the slides. And one of the biggest problems in video conferencing is that people leave the slides on for far too long, but I can also easily bring them back when I need to show them again. In this video, we looked at three ways of adding PowerPoint slides to your OBS setup. Let me know in the comments below the video which of these three methods is the best fit for the way you like to share slides. If you want to learn more about using OBS Studio, particularly for video conferencing, then click or tap the screen right here. That's my full playlist of OBS tutorials right here on my channel. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video.